The 11th method of antigravity is affected mechanically by the relative motion between conductors and magnets. Repulsion between a magnet and a metallic conductor is induced by relative motion, as shown in the 5th method of magnetic mechanical constraint, repulsion, or attraction of like poles, where I introduce the concept of domain theory of magnetism and when an inducing magnetic field is present, the domains in some metals are kept aligned, and when the inducing magnet is removed, the alignment collapses. Also, if you refer to the previous method 10, electromagnetic suspension, repulsion or attraction with feedback loop control, I demonstrated briefly the relative motion between conductors using a permanent magnet, which would require a mechanical system such as your hand, as shown, and was achieved by the relative motion between conductors and magnets and the inherent diamagnetism of aluminium, referring to method 8 of diamagnetic, pyrolytic, graphite, bismuth, etc. Eddy currents induced in a conductor produce repulsive forces, including levitation and lateral forces, and a retardation force. According to Lenzs' law, induced currents will at every instant flow in a conductor in a direction to oppose any changes in the applied magnetic flux. If the current varies, the associated magnetic flux also changes in direct proportion, causing a back electromagnetic force. This is self-inductance and provides back electromagnetic force, which is the mirror image of the magnetic flux generated by the magnet, such as is produced by the Meissner effect, referring to method 7, and represented as forces of repulsion between a metallic conductor. A retardation force is also generated by the electromagnetic field. This can be demonstrated simply using a slight gradient of a non-ferromagnetic conductor, preferably of aluminium or copper. Brass has also been used, but the repulsive force is weakened due to the lower conductivity properties. On the viewer's left-hand side is a rare earth magnet, and on the viewer's right, a copper coin of similar dimensions. As can be seen, both do not attract the aluminium slide in any way, because it's non-ferrous metal. The only elements that can attract magnets are ferromagnetic substances, such as iron, steel, and nickel and cobalt, which show magnetic properties strongly when subject to a magnetizing force. When they are released on the aluminium slide, the copper coin falls with a time rate consistent with acceleration due to the gravitational attraction of massive bodies. But the magnet fall is somewhat retarded by approximately a third. In the same way that a rotating magnet generates electricity in a coiled conductive copper wire, the same effect is achieved in a linear conductor such as the aluminium slide. The same principle applies to a magnet that is rapidly moved back and forth underneath the same copper coin. This is because the changing flux generates currents inside the coins that in turn generate a magnetic field, hence the magnetic effect. A far more spectacular demonstration is shown using a tube of aluminium or copper and allowing a magnet to drop within. Once again, the gentle reduced fall or levitation follows the same principle of a moving magnet. As the magnet falls, it moves past the aluminium and will also vibrate the charges in some materials, generating a small amount of electricity. This electricity creates another magnetic field that pushes up against the falling magnet, slowing it down, and is also called magnetic braking. What if we move the magnet extremely fast, such as spinning it with a motor? Here we spin a magnet, creating a rotating magnetic field over another magnet that is sitting on top of a base plate made of a very good electrical conductor, such as copper, silver, or, as in this experiment, aluminium. The distance of the suspended magnet is just a fraction above a point where it would attract to the top magnet, but is counterbalanced by the force of gravity resting on top of the aluminium base plate. Having established that relative motion can levitate a moving magnet over an aluminium plate, In this experiment, an offset magnet is spun over an aluminium ball, a conductor, to cut the flux of the magnetic field, producing an induced electromagnetic force across the conductor. Current set in a substance by variation of the applied magnetic field is called eddy currents. The induced currents produce a magnetic field above the aluminium ball conductor, which opposes the original rotating magnetic field, and the ball is ejected away after having achieved levitation. Energy is dissipated by eddy currents, usually in the form of heat. Eddy currents in the moving conductor also react with the magnetic field to produce retardation of the motion, and thus have a damping effect on the motion. In antigravity method 9 of 15, magnetic gyroscopic levitation, I introduced a device that minimized eddy currents that flowed, as this will dampen and stop the magnet from spinning. In this experiment, a magnet is restrained from moving in the same direction as the conductor, otherwise it will travel with the conductor. The aluminium conductor disc rotates at 50 Hz or 3000 RPM. The concept demonstrates that a permanent magnet is repelled by a rapidly spinning disc of conductive metal. The magnet levitates above the disc's surface. Pressing the magnet down slows the disc. The next experiment follows from the previous, but instead of using a disc, we can also obviously use two diamagnetic or paramagnetic conductors that rotate at high speed side by side to each other. A magnetic well should form from the induced currents that produce two magnetic fields above the conductor, which opposes the original magnetic field. This magnetic levitation of a group of very small magnets is levitated and achieved by the attraction towards the center, as governed by the rotation towards the center. This configuration also suspends the magnets when flipped upside down. A greater height is achieved with various magnetic geometries as shown here. The outer magnets are ferrite magnets and the inner larger magnets are samarium cobalt, and the smaller ones are neodymium iron boron. An even greater levitating height can be achieved in a number of ways, by rotating the conductors away from each other, which is still counterclockwise but rotating outwards, also by increasing the diameter of the conductors. The ones shown are now 16 millimeters in diameter with a wall thickness of 3.5 millimeters. The magnets are the strongest of the permanent magnets available, which are neodymium iron boron. A clear plastic guide around the rollers also helps by preventing the magnets from being ejected by the rollers and helps stabilization as well as providing finger protection. This arrangement provides an improved magnetic levitation system for the levitation and lateral stabilization of a body. The magnet to be levitated is maintained in an equilibrium position above the two rotating tubes that also form a guideway. The rigidity of the levitation is at least in part achieved by the orientation of the axis through the poles of the magnet in a direction parallel to the direction of relative motion between the magnet and the conductor. The shown levitation is achieved and stable at approximately 6,000 RPM or 100 Hz and begins to work at approximately 4,600 RPM or 77 Hz with the diameters and materials previously stated. A high speed such as 15,000 RPM or 250 Hz and applied voltage of 48 volts DC achieves high levitation but becomes less stable as it becomes attracted to the magnetic field produced by the motors, as the length of each aluminium cylinder is only 150 millimeters. The stabilizing magnets had to be removed at this speed as they interfered with the stability of the levitating magnets, as the levitation is higher and pushed out from the rollers and not inwards as with the previous. Longer tube roller lengths of a larger diameter should improve performance, but the disadvantage would be that the device would have to be larger and would require larger, more powerful motors or a motor.